serve and not put this in it, but the way I serve my God. So I really enjoy this and I'm happy to see you guys here today. And happy to be a part of the Miami High baseball team. Let's do get to meet and work with the coaches, Coach Howard, Coach Boyd, my father, Coach Beck. Learned a lot from them. They're great people, great friends. Anything that I need or the players need, they're there to assist, they're there to help. So my goal today is not to be long with this program. We're going to go ahead and get through it so we can get something to eat. And present these awards and get home. So next we will have the welcome and the occasion by Monty Haynes, which is the team captain. He is also a graduating senior. We expect great things from him in the coming years and very proud of him. So we're going to go ahead and go with the welcome.
Thank you, everybody. My name is Monty Haynes. Proud of being an alum. We are as alum now. I just want to welcome y'all to NBDRA's Major Athletes Baseball. And I just want to say, first and foremost, I'm thankful for you. Throughout these last few years, it's been like real rough, but it's been good at the same time. All my teammates, someone to do this one, stuff like that. Appreciate you all y'all.
Thank you, Mr. Pat. Good afternoon. It's really a pleasure to be here this afternoon. Thank you guys so much for your support. I'm honored to be here. And I want to commend Mr. Pat Sr. and his staff for working very hard with the team and for making this happen on here tonight. Unfortunately for the other sports, we weren't able to make this happen, but baseball did. They said they were doing it and they had no way. So I'm very thankful for that. I want to commend these young men and coaches for what I consider to be a development with an outstanding season. You know, there's a difference between a winning team and a winning program. A winning program is a foundation built from the bottom up for the future. A winning team may win 1 year, next year they may not. But if you develop the team, the young players, and bring them up, then certainly year after year you can duplicate or replicate what you have done the year before. That's what I see with these coaches and with these young players. And one thing I want to say to the players, you know, to be a good baseball player, it takes a lot of work. It takes a lot of effort. It's more difficult probably than any game that you possibly play. The pitch is about 6 feet away from you, 6 inches. Sometimes they throw up as much as 100 miles per hour. That gives you about 2 tenths of a second to decide if it's a fastball, curveball, and get ready to hit the ball. You can do that, you've got good hand-eye coordination. And before I go too far, I want to say that when I was a Griffiths coach, Ben Junior was one of my players at one time before he became a big rat. But he got his start over there in the deal. But congratulations to him. You know, I knew great things was going to happen for him, and probably even more when the thing was going to come. But to be a good baseball player, you really need self-strengthening to believe in yourself. You got to have some mental toughness. If you strike out one time, don't get down. Come back up. Some of the greats have struck out 3 or 4 times in the game, but they come back the next day, maybe hit 2 or 3 home runs. You got to believe in yourself. The next thing, you got to have a mission. You just can't want to do it. You got to have that work to make it happen. Even though it's a team sport, it's about as individual as it possibly be. When you're the batter and they call the Yankee, you got to make that play. It becomes a team sport when you have to turn a double play, a help, a system play. But you are that one that's responsible. So, and then you got to have a degree of progression. When you're pitching, you're the man on the mound. Don't worry about that. That I gotta take care of himself. If he's trying to take all the blame, he can't have it all. Bust him back, even if he had to hit the dirt. So I'm saying, display sportsmanship, but display those kinds of things that are gonna make you the best player that you could possibly be. And these supportive parents, I'm so appreciative to what you all have done. This is probably the smallest team in numbers when I got that program. But you have done the most in terms of supporting your players, being there when needed. Baseball is probably the one sport this year who really been self-supporting. And we certainly appreciate that. So tonight, I bring to you from all of us here at the Parents Association. I like what I see. I like what I'm hearing from my players. And guys, you don't get down. The one game I was most impressed with, I saw some good things in a lot of it. But that game against North Florida, where we missed the girls in the first inning, a few balls dropped here and there, and we got down 13 to nothing. But after that, we shut them down the rest of the way. So that's the tribute to you and your heart. You'll believe in yourself and the man you are in spirit. So I look forward to another season already. I wish this one over. Didn't get a chance to spend much time with them, but baseball is my passion. It's going to bring the passion. And somebody said it used to be pretty good. And they said it used to be. Okay. So thank you guys so much for being here. Thank you so much for giving me an opportunity to say a few words on the program. And thank you again. Continue to support the young people and family girls this month. Have a good evening.
Thank you, Dr. Hightower. I have the mic now, so I can review. But anyway, congratulations to everybody. This is going to start it off with Coach Beck and myself saying we're going to take baseball, softball, and track in condition. And you can see the foot of it in the different teams. Got off to a good start. Track didn't have a whole lot of older bodies, but they performed well. Softball did well, baseball did well. So the vision was to get everybody together, get them going, and get them in some kind of shape. Conditioning is important. And Dr. Hightower kind of told me some stuff about you know, you have to have a ball and a bat. In my neighborhood, which is good for you, we are talking about that. Over on 4th Avenue, you can take a tin cap and a soda cap, if y'all know about it either. Soda cap and a stick. And you can take a soda cap. Yeah. You don't have to have, you need a coach, but you don't have to have a coach. You can throw the ball against the wall by yourself. You can swing the bat 100 times in front of the mirror. Because it's the speed of the bat, doesn't matter how big you are, it's the speed of the bat in the zone. So I'm not at practice, I'm swinging that bat 100 times. Then I go to practice. Coach gonna do so much. But then you gotta do, like I would say, it's an issue. Take it upon yourself. Run for the extra laps. I'm not getting tired today, because I'm around my own. I'm a catch on my own. I had a weighted bat, a couple of them. I had a weighted bat, I had a weighted ball. I lobbed the ball, and I swing the weighted bat, so I had an advantage when I went to that. I don't know how much I'm supposed to say up there, but baseball is a passion, as I said. We used to play in the neighborhood. The parents would come out and play with them, the kids. And we would play Spain and Marie. We know nothing about that either. So we try to get out. I throw the ball. It's a rubber ball. Yeah. So I didn't go back and look at it. But the parents, it was a neighborhood thing. And I would say, you know, a privilege to be able to play baseball. Because in some schools, you cannot. there was a meeting. Now, the roof is like $2,500, and such as $1,000. So, you have a wonderful opportunity to coach this, and I think I commend them too. I see them in action too. But you have a wonderful opportunity here to play baseball, like baseball. All right? Because I was at Henry State, one black student and white kid. One black player and white kid. All right? So take advantage of it. As I said, coaching going so much. It's up to you. Practice on your own. When you feel get up, listen to your coaches,
what they say,
but then go that extra mile, that extra effort, and you'll be a much better player. Everybody on the field, the pros, everybody on the list, everybody on the back. But then you're going to see my own certificate. So, get your education. You may get a ride college on a baseball scholarship, and then your parents are not paying that much money, so much money, come out of your pocket. I'm always evaluating. I see somebody walking down the hallway, the way they carry itself, and then when I look at the grandmother, that's going to be a key as to the memory, as to how tall I can get. We're here to celebrate y'all, honor you. This is a good thing. We're going to try to do something with the other sports, but we give honor to Coach Peck for pulling it off. He has nice certificates and nice awards for you. This is awesome. Thank you.
All right. Now we have an inspirational moment from Mr. Earl Murray.
Thank you, sir. Certainly glad to be with you all tonight. Administration here, give honor to Dr. Hightower. We got a lot of history here. Amen. When I was a little bitty down in the middle school, Dr. Hightower was my coach. You see what I got up here now. Amen. He looks younger than I do. We thank God for him. He really agreed baseball where he comes from. So baseball is history. Coach Beck, I've been going all my life. When you come, you should call him sooner. Y'all remember. Amen. But we're here to fill in an inspiration moment, and when you give a preacher a microphone, you kind of mess up. Amen. But talk to young folk. I want to read you a scripture that I want you to listen to. When you go home, get your Bible, and remember this. Ecclesiastes 12:1. We can't do anything without the power of God. Coach Beck was talking about spirit. And there's no greater spirit than the spirit of God. Ecclesiastes chapter 12. Remember not thy creator in the days of your youth. While the evil days come not, nor the years draw nigh, when thou shalt say, I have no pleasure in them. While the sun or the light or the moon or the stars be not dark, nor the clouds return after the rain. In the day when the keepers of the house shall tremble, and the strong men shall bow themselves, and the grinders cease because they are few, and those that look out of the window be dark, and the door shall be shut in the streets when the sound of the grinding is low, and he shall rise up the voice of the bird, and all the dawn of the beast shall be brought low. Also, when they shall be afraid of that which is high, and fear shall be in the way, and the almond tree shall flourish, and the grasshopper shall be a bird, and the desire shall fail, because man goeth into his long home, and the mourners go about the streets, for ever the silver cord be loosed, or the golden bough be broken. Or the pitcher be broken at the fountain, or the wheels broken at the cistern. Then shall the dust return to the earth as it were, and the spirit shall return unto God who gave it. Vanity of vanities, saith the preacher. all his damage. And moreover, because the preacher was wise, he still taught the people knowledge. Yea, he gave good heed and sought out, and said in order many proverbs. The preacher sought to find out acceptable words, and that which was written was not right, even the words of truth. The words of the wise are as gold, and as the nails fastened by the master of assembly, which are given from one shepherd. And father, by these my son, be admonished, for making many books there is no end, and much study is a weariness of flesh. Let us hear the conclusion of the whole matter. Fear God, keep his commandments, for this is the whole duty of man. For God shall bring every work into judgment, with every secret thing, whether it be good or whether it be evil. And this scripture talks about life. It talks about from the time you were born to the time that you died. The almond tree, hair turned white, the grind of your teeth, your footsteps, your eyesight. This is the whole remedy of life. And this Ecclesiastes 12 gives us encouragement to fear God, trust God, obey God. And as long as you obey God, keep God first in everything else, for me to pray. Seek ye first the kingdom and all of his righteousness, and everything else will be added to you. We just encourage you, young men, to have a great season. You got great coaching. And we just encourage you to keep up the good work. And as the young man said, practice on your own. Never give up. Regardless. Let me tell you what a failure is, a loser. It's someone that never tried. When you give it your best, you're a winner. Regardless of what the score says, put your heart in it. Do the best you can. Be proud. But if you make your coaches proud, make your parents proud, make me proud. Now, I don't come to baseball games. I don't like sports at all. But I support financially. That's my favorite brother. I never played sports. I never liked sports. But if you like it, I love it for you. And I want you to be the best that you can be at. Amen. I know we're hungry, but one more thing. I want y'all to help me sing. I'm not a singer, but oh Lord, call him. Call him like you need him. We got a line of him, old familiar him. Guide me. Oh, thy great Jehovah. Pilgrim through this barren land. I am weak, but thou art mighty. Hold me with thy powerful hand. Bread of heaven, feed me. So I won't stand up. They won't help me stand. Church, morning.
In your favor.